You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
So me and Apache, I mean Apache and me, are over here by this dragon slash giant hangout. I'm still trying her out to see what she can all do with things. Level 50 something. Wearing just a dress. You know, is she bulletproof? Does she have unlimited magic? Will she get beat up by a giant? You know, that kind of thing. Whoa.
I'll kill you instead.
Sometimes the giants fight the dragons fight the mammoths fight the giants, you know, that kind of thing. It just never ends. Likes to hide behind things. It's kind of cool, but kind of annoying at the same time.
Now that's a real man.
What, the giant's still alive? Let's get away from the giant. Mammoths run pretty fast. I don't think I can't keep up with one if I chase one. If they're on fire, they run in the opposite direction. There should be like a random generator that says, oh, the mammoth is pissed, it's on fire, and it's running right towards you. But no, that would be too much. Too much math. But it would be nice once in a while for a mammoth to just go berserk on you. It has nothing to lose. It's on fire, it's gonna die, and it's gonna take you with it. It's gonna push you off a cliff, that kind of a thing. But for now, with the AIs I've got installed, the mammoths just run away as far away as they can until they're out of the picture. So I just have to run, get caught up with current events. Okay, where's the mammoth?
And you thought I was just a pretty face.
Okay, it's, oh, they found a hag to fight.
I'm sorry, but you left me with no choice.
And I can never find the hag in this place. It's always too dark, too much grass. If something died in the grass, it's lost. It's gone. See? The elephant's gonna get... It's finally getting killed by the frost and fire mages down here. What? It lived? No way! It's coming after me!
And you thought I was just a pretty
face. Oh, it's a zombie. It's a zombie mammoth. Okay, I thought it was the real deal. It was just a zombie. Ah, what next? And this is just my another day in Skyrim. This is all this is. Just me going around, killing stuff, breaking stuff. As I fetch one item to give to another person. Stuff that happens in between the scenes. I got too many mods. So I'm up to 248 ESP files now. So I've got room for what? Maybe 6 more mods and then I'm done. Stick a fork in it, it's done. So soon I'm going to be at the point where I'm going to have to get rid of mods that I can live without. They were fun to have. They had their chance and, you know, their time in the sun or whatever it's called, their day in the sun. And now I can probably get rid of them after the fact.
Well, hey there. Let's go.
Or I can condense two mods together. Like a newer mod will come out that sort of redoes what an older mod used to do, but does it better. So I don't need the old mod anymore. And what is it? I got this sex lab attraction thing. Still not sure how it works. There's no documentation for it. It's kind of clever what it does do. I go to a lover's lab to see what people are saying about it, but the majority of the posts are, this mod doesn't work. Well, the mod was written in 2014. And it was written for mods that were written in 2014. So that's what I'm doing. I'm using mods that were written in 2014.
Hello again.
So it works fine for me.
All right then.
But most people want to have the latest, greatest version of all the mods. And when you do that, you have to compromise on some things.
Dragons breathing fire in the sky. Vampires brazenly attacking people on the street. It's the end of the world, I tell you.
Normally the way modding works is some kid during his free time makes an awesome mod. Then he has to go to school because he's getting a degree in something. You know, he wants to be somebody when he grows up.
What can I do for you?
So he retires from modding and he says, "Hey, here's the source code. You want to make edits or changes to it? Go ahead." And no one knows how to do what he did, and they try to change the code, make some changes and make some mods to the mod, and they end up making it into a cluster. So that happens a lot. I just keep using what was written before. It works. It just works.
Let me know if there's anything else.
It may not be the latest greatest. Like, I'm a huge fan of the Sex Lab framework, but I'm using an ancient Sex Lab framework. I'm not using the latest one. The latest one has all the bells and whistles that I don't need. I'm not trying to do porn movies.
What about Ulfric? Did you ever
I want the mods I do have, I want them to still have their video game-ish quality to them.
What did he say? He thanked us for contacting him. but said they didn't need any more lumber at the moment.
Oh. You know, I like that there's a hint of sex crimes going on in my game. I don't need it to be like AAA standard though. Cause then you're not playing Skyrim anymore. Cause I've mentioned this before. My goal with Skyrim is to play Skyrim. Even with all the mods, I still want my game to be Skyrim. At the end of the day. So I noticed one of my prostitutes is not essential, so I'm gonna set her to be essential. I should just go into that guy's mod. Who's his? Manny GT, is that his name? I need to go into this mod, Prostitutes of Skyrim, and just make everyone essential. Problem solved. But, I mean, sometimes I'm in the mood that, you know, yeah, kill the prostitutes.
What can I do for
let
you?
Werewolves and vampires come through the town and just massacre the prostitutes. And then sometimes I'm in the mood where I need extra people in my towns, otherwise I'll have ghost towns. So I want my prostitutes to stay alive. Okay, what's going on with her? Something about her clothes were bolted on. This dress of hers.
All the apiaries. It will take years to get those bees happy again.
Do the bees need to be happy?
Of course.
No matter what I would give her, she would not wear it. She would insist on wearing this blue dress. I don't blame her, but for story purposes, I need her to wear something else.
What can I do for you, friend? Of course.
You need to take better care of your sister.
So she won't wear the she won't wear that.
Let me know anything.
Because she was being stupid.
Don't make me bring your father into this.
So luxury suites comes with the dialogue to change people's outfits. Their default outfit.
I'm not sure that's a good joke to tell with women present.
So that's what she's got on now.
Get it? She thought he was a troll. Oh, I get it. It's funny.
So the luxury suites is aware of this NPC. That's kind of cool. So if I ever lose the dress, I'll have a way of giving it back to her.
Let me know if you need anything.
So the shoes, the dress, and the earrings all come as one thing. So to get rid of the earring,
buy a lady a drink? Well, hey there.
She can't just wear the dress without the earring. Nope, she has to have the earrings. But this is the way Apache does things. All the Apache mods come with earrings. You're sort of stuck with them.
Take a look, Dragonborn. Is there some way I can assist you?
So after fiddle farting around, found some clothes that might match, that she'll hang on to.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Seems to be, for now.
Well, hey there.
Tavern outfits.
Sure thing.
I want her to wear an outfit that, during combat, she'll start looting dead bodies and grabbing better stuff to wear.
Is there anything else you need?
And then over time, she's dressed to kill. So what do we got on now? This is that outfit chopped up. It's a mini skirt version, looks like. I must have been doing that out in the front yard. Because it don't look like that when I wear it.
Good to see you. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. Until next time.
And then something I installed is interfering with the innkeepers. I don't know if it's an inventory thing or what, but they, after I buy a room from them, they stand there for a good, you know, 5 game minutes, and then they get up and say, "Okay, let me show you to your room."
I'll show you to your room, right this way.
Okay, don't block the door. So I don't know, something about her merchant. The stuff she has for sale, I think that was still generating. Maybe she thought I was going to kill her, and she was getting ready to fill up her loot crate so that when I kill her, I can open up her loot crate. That happens a lot now. NPCs just assume that I'm going to murder them. So when they see me, they immediately start filling up their valuables in a their little safety, you know, what do they call those things? Deposit boxes for me to open upon their death. But I don't think I have any loot mods installed, but something I installed, it just kind of triggers that. It only does it once though. When I re-meet an NPC, they already know what they've got in case I kill them. They don't have to regenerate it again. And then that started happening right before my audio issues happened. When my new sound card settings for Skyrim, which I didn't have before. I want to blame OBS because I was streaming some Skyrim a couple weeks ago and OBS got a huge update and it hooks into my Skyrim, so I'm wondering if it made some changes to the audio in my game.
Need a ride?
I am not a fan at all of programs hooking into other programs.
Once was a hero named Ragnar, riding to Rightrun from old Rorik's dead.